It is officially the second week of September, with the PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series X rumored to be only about 2 months away. Everyone's getting ready to begin the next generation of console gaming. But there's one issue. We still don't know how much they'll cost us. And as implied by the fact that I had to say rumored 2 months away, we also still don't know when they'll launch either. And people are pretty annoyed by that. Sony's already putting out advertisements for their machine, but they don't have dates or prices attached to them. Meanwhile, the Xbox Series S is probably the worst kept secret in the gaming industry right now, but Microsoft has yet to even announce it. There are many signs that a new generation is about to start, but it kinda doesn't feel like it. We lack crucial information. At the risk of this video becoming ridiculously outdated within the next couple of weeks, I want to give my thoughts about the whole thing and offer my own predictions for the prices of the consoles, and also respond to the idea that's been floating around that they need to be delayed. This is all speculation on my part, so I could end up being extremely wrong in every aspect. So why are Sony and Microsoft engaged in such a long-lasting game of price chicken? What's behind it? And does it actually matter at the end of the day? Now obviously we need to know the prices of these things before we buy them, and not knowing them as the holiday creeps closer is pretty annoying, as it does make both companies seem secretive and unwilling to be transparent, which is cause enough to be frustrated. Companies who aren't forthright about these details always look suspicious as more time goes on. Before this generation began, we were given the price of the Xbox One and PS4 at E3 2013, which was 5 months before they launched. Now we're sitting here, supposedly only 2 months off from a new generation starting, and that same information is still unknown to us. But of all the things that we're upset about, price might be the least important, as it's unlikely to end up being above a certain point. Hear me out on this one. I think it's safe to assume neither console will pass $499, as going beyond that would be terrible optics, especially for Sony, who already knows firsthand how badly a high price will reflect on them, as demonstrated by the PlayStation 3. But the thing about the PS3 is that it was expensive due to the Blu-ray drive, which was brand spanking new technology that wasn't previously available for years prior. Despite the PS3 being so expensive, it was actually still the cheapest Blu-ray player available at the time, and that fact ended up helping it and the format a lot. Sony currently puts a spotlight on the PS5's blazing fast SSD, but M.2 SSDs are not super new. They've been available for some time, and plenty of PC gamers already have one installed in their rig as their boot drive at the very least, including me. According to a Bloomberg article from way back in February, the PlayStation 5's manufacturing costs were at around $450 per unit. You may think this is high enough to warrant pushing the MSRP past $500, but in that same article, it's mentioned that the PS4's cost was $381, and that launched at a price of $399, only $18 more. Now, the PS4 still sold at a loss of about $60 per unit due to things like retailer margins and such, but it wasn't enough to make Sony sweat, as they still anticipated making up for it through game sale royalties and PlayStation Plus subscriptions. It took only a few months for the PS4 to finally turn a profit off its $399 price tag. I think it's safe to assume that the Series X has manufacturing costs around the same price as the PS5, and will likely hover at around $499 MSRP as well. But all of this begs the question, if they're both almost certainly going to settle on that number, why are they waiting so long to announce prices? It's pretty clear that they're playing price chicken, but personally I think their silence also denotes a willingness to take a small loss if it means undercutting the other product, which is why they're waiting for one another to flinch first. If Sony caves and makes the mistake of sticking to $499, Microsoft could capitalize by pricing the Series X at $449, giving them an edge on price while also advertising better graphical performance, whether it ends up being true or not. But if Sony comes out with $449 from the get-go, it puts the ball in Microsoft's court to either take a larger loss than them, or cave and make the Series X the same price, which is ultimately what's best for consumers because we get lower prices all around. One of them may be feeling ballsy enough to go all the way down to $399. It wouldn't be totally out of the question, as the PlayStation 3 sold at a massive $200 to $300 loss when it first launched, depending on which model you bought. and the Xbox 360 sold at a loss of about $153. And in the former's case, this was before PlayStation Plus existed to help mitigate those losses. Both companies are no stranger to risks. I don't think such risks will be taken here, but I could be surprised. Basically, just assume that either machine will end up being $499. If you're extra paranoid, then add another $100. Not knowing the number for absolute certain so close to launch is indeed frustrating, but there's only a tiny range that they'd realistically go for. Just play it safe and assume it's on the higher end of that. On the Microsoft side of things, how does this affect the rumored but borderline confirmed Series S? It's almost common knowledge that it exists in some form, yet Microsoft hasn't officially announced it. So what gives? Frankly, I think they're aware of how bad it would look to announce a second model before revealing the price of the first. Plus, there's no guarantee that Series S would actually launch alongside Series X to begin with. It might come out in December, or maybe even the beginning of 2021. Who knows? I've seen rumors of another PlayStation event happening soon, but there's nothing substantial to support it right now, so I won't go into detail. Microsoft, however, has confirmed they'll show up at Tokyo Game Show, but also stated that no new next-gen news will be shared. So would the launch date be announced beforehand? According to Video Games Chronicle, they have both developer and retail sources that state the Series X is targeting a launch within the first week of November, and the PlayStation 5 is to follow a week or two after. Some may feel that cutting it so close is a hint of a delay, but both companies have been very adamant, even through the very height of the pandemic, that they'll be committing to a holiday 2020 release. There's also the fact that they likely don't want to miss the Christmas window. Speaking of delay, I've also seen a lot of people rumbling about how Sony and Microsoft should delay the release of their next-gen consoles, as they perceive the lack of price and date announcements to be signs of their lack of preparation. Frankly, I think that's pretty ridiculous. As I stated before, I think there's reason enough for the silence on price, and I would be downright shocked if either were more than $499. The launch date silence, however, is pretty strange, admittedly. Maybe they're playing it safe in that regard just in case they want to buy some time to manufacture more units, but neither company has a large window to work with before they miss the beginning of the Christmas season. So if they're sticking to the holiday 2020 window, November is probably as late as it's going to be, at least in North America. I've also seen some worries about a possibility of low availability, which is understandable because the launch of every new console sees stock shortages everywhere for a while. However, Nikkei and Bloomberg have both reported that Sony has ordered a 50% production increase for this year, bumping expected manufactured units up to 9 to 10 million, which is double the PlayStation 4's number of 4.5 million for the last several weeks of 2013. I don't think such a large-scale production is the sign of an impending delay. Unfortunately, I don't have any numbers pertaining to 2020 units for the Series X, but supposedly it began production back in early May, so its figures could be in the same ballpark. Basically, a shortage should actually be less of an issue now than it was at the launch of this gen that's ending, so I don't think it's worth worrying about. Certain stores in certain cities will likely still be sold out depending on how many units they receive, as not all chains and locations receive the same amount, but that's just how these things go. Then there's games and concerns over launch lineups, and to be blunt, I don't think Sony has any reason to worry here from a first-party perspective. Spider-Man Miles Morales is not outright confirmed to be a launch title right now, but it will still be out this year, likely close to day one of PS5's launch, if not spot on day one. Considering how insanely popular the first game was, Miles Morales will carry the PS5 for a couple of weeks on its own. There's also Demon's Souls, which was raided in South Korea a week after Miles Morales, which is a strong hint that it could release near launch as well, because ratings for games in Korea tend to only happen about 2 to 3 months before they're out. It would be a massive deal if both Miles Morales and Demon's Souls were launch titles. Microsoft is the only one that might be sweating here, because the loss of Halo Infinite as a launch title is a pretty big blow, but they could still surprise us. Plus, there's third-party games for both platforms, like Fortnite, Assassin's Creed Valhalla, Call of Duty, Black Ops, Cold War, Watch Dogs, Legion, Rainbow Six Siege, Outriders, Dirt 5, and others I'm probably forgetting. All of those are within launch window. And at the end of the day, a console doesn't need a good day one lineup to launch. Some machines in the past have had downright terrible launch titles, or just one or two decent ones before a several month long drought, which the PS4 actually went through. I remember it. I spent most of the PS4's first year still playing PS3 games. It wasn't until early 2015 that the PS4 finally saw more use and became my main gaming platform. Then there's the fact that the lead up to next gen just feels lackluster in general, due in no small part to the lack of information, which is understandable. I can see why it makes one doubt the status of these machines as ready to launch in just 2 months. There's no prices for these things, no launch date for them, or their games, and it's pretty frustrating. We still haven't even seen the PlayStation 5's UI and what new features it will have. I do agree it's really annoying, but I just don't think there's any real reason to delay the start of next gen, especially when there's likely millions of units for each console already sitting in warehouses around the world right now. The lack of hype is just the result of two companies playing chicken. It's stupid and doesn't look consumer friendly, but if they're so adamant on launching this holiday, then they will crack. And if the first one to do so gives a competitive price that goes under our expectations, that's a win for the consumers. So yeah, that's basically all my thoughts on the matter. It's all just speculation on my part, and I could be super wrong about everything, but this stuff has been on my mind for a bit and I just wanted to air my thoughts. Hopefully we receive news sooner rather than later. And if we do, maybe I'll make another video on it. Until then, thank you for watching, and I'll see you around.